Hey, Brett McFall, and in this lesson, I want to teach you about the most important thing to do in a presentation. It is so rare these days to see someone who's getting it right. So it means that if you do this, you'll really, really stand out. And it's all around, you know, there's three parts to a great presentation: the message, the journey, and the opportunity. This is all about the first section, the message, because if you get this right, then people will stay tuned to you the whole presentation. This is what you want to spend a whole bunch of time on, and virtually no one spends enough time on this, okay? So what I'm going to teach, I'm going to go to my computer in a second, I'm going to teach you how to think about it. I want to teach you the psychology around it so that you understand it. It's not just about finding, you know, like, what's my headline for my presentation. It's more about finding the message that is going to keep people hooked on to your presentation and desperately wanting to go further with you and your coaching because of that clear message that you're getting out there. So I'm going to teach you what to ask of yourself to find your message, right? And I'm going to teach you based around four things. Four things only. Choose one of them, not all of them, choose one of them. And this way, when you do a presentation, your audience will always remember what it was about. You know, so many people these days are jamming their presentation with information, and so you can be the person who actually just makes it nice and clear for your audience. The way that, you know, Steve Jobs used to do with Apple and their product, he just made it so easy to remember and to understand, and that's what I'm going to show you how to do and teach you how to do in this video. So I'm going to go to my into my video right now on the computer and then make it nice and easy for you, ask you some questions, give you some things to do. I would grab your pen and a piece of paper if that's how you take notes, and just get yourself thinking along these lines, and just making this change alone to your presentation will make a huge difference, a huge difference. All right? That's how important this is. So let's go to my computer right now, and I will show you how to get your message right. Okay, watch this.
The question is this: what is the one message you want to get across? That's what you need to answer. What is the one message you want to get across? For instance, is it based around speed? Are you the fastest solution, or are you the slowest solution? As in, you know, we bake the slowest cookies in the world, which would emphasize that the speed is slow, so the quality must be good. Make sense? So you might be the fastest or you might be the slowest. You take more care or you make things happen faster. You have better systems. What is it? What is the one message you want to get across? Is that you are the fastest method to the end goal? The slowest method to the end goal? Or is it that you solve a problem? Are you a problem solver? Are you a solution to a problem? If that's the case, then what is the problem? What is the problem you solve? Are you perhaps new onto the scene? You got something brand new to tell, brand new to help. Is that what it is? Or are you quality? Are you all about the quality, the fact that you're better than other options, other solutions? Okay, so what is the one message you want to get across? Decide in one of these four areas. There are other areas as well you could go into, but in this presentation, we'll just focus on four. Which one of these four are you? I'll give you examples. Let's say you were to choose speed. Example, the fastest way to invest for profit if you're age 40 or over. See how clear that is? So your presentation is simply called the fastest way to invest for profit if you're age 40 or over. Now immediately I know whether I'm in the market or not in the market. And the fact that it's the fastest way, that's enticing. But it's very clear as to why I would listen to your presentation. That's the key. I want to get that one solution out of your presentation. That answers what's in it for me. Again, that makes the audience feel good, right? Or if you're a problem-based, so maybe your message is that here are the three big mistakes most people make when it comes to XYZ, whatever it is your topic, okay? Here are the three big mistakes most people make, and your presentation is all about the three big mistakes. Or is it that you're new, okay? So an example would be introducing the first dating site made specifically for people who wear glasses. And by the way, this is actually a site which has just been released, by the way. The first dating site made specifically for people who wear glasses. So it's a sub-niche now of the dating niche. But they're the first. People remember that. Okay, so this can go into your marketing. It goes everywhere. Or if you're the quality solution, then the example would be, here's why this product will last three times longer than any other on the market. So in your sales presentation, that's the core message. 3 times longer, or 4 times longer, or 5 times longer. You would decide the parameters. But that alone, just getting down to one message, is what was so awesome about Steve Jobs, who from Apple. Very good at drumming the message into one thing. Just one main point, so you don't forget it. So the goal, in terms of your message, is to choose one message only and drive that message home for the whole presentation. That's the goal. That's what most people just don't do. The old way was to tell them a whole bunch of stuff. The new way, one message only, nice and easy to accept, and you'll be ahead of everybody else because everyone else is trying to jam more information into their presentations these days. Have you noticed? Because of the internet, is that the internet gives you so much more access to information, and we're used to handling big loads of information from Facebook, from Google, from all the favorite websites and apps that we have. So to stand out, you just offer one message, and you hammer on that message throughout the whole presentation. All right? So for instance, what I do often in a seminar is I'll grab 12 tennis balls, okay? I'll have somebody come up on stage, help me out. I'll say, I'm going to throw you one tennis ball. And the audience are going to watch it happen. And I throw the tennis ball to them, literally maybe a distance of maybe 1 meter, 1 meter, 2 meters. And they catch the ball. And the audience applauds because I threw the ball and they caught it. Then I say, now, I now have a bucket full of 12 tennis balls. I'm going to throw these. I just toss them up at you and see how many you can catch. So I toss the 12 balls. The balls go everywhere. And that person may be lucky enough to catch one, maybe two, maybe three. And you might think, well, what's the point of that? Well, what I'm demonstrating is that there was nothing wrong with the quality of the ball. They were nice and bright. They were nice and furry. But what was the problem was the quantity, in that our brains can only handle one thing at a time. If I was to take each of those 12 balls and I was to toss them very gently at the person catching them, but I tossed them one by one. There's one. There's one. There's one. Is there a higher chance of them catching it or a lower chance? Higher, right? Because one at a time. That's how we accept information the most effectively. One thing at a time. Not 5 or 6 messages at once. And that's the point I make by that demonstration. Hopefully you understand and remember my tennis ball example here. It's so important. One message at a time.